family, you know, 1 in 5 people do not find job. 1 in 4 people do not find job, which was not at all the case 5 years ago. Now people say it cannot be because of, you know, people's leisure preference has gone up or such things, or people have certainly started searching more than they were doing before. So there must be some other cause, and this was the cause for which unemployment was done. Now, when all this was over, it took a rather strange turn over time. Because people accepted that how much you produce, demand for labor depends on how much labor produces, but it changed to the notion that how you grow, how much is your growth of output, it's still the same transmission, end-to-end transmission mechanism, but how much you produce, how fast you grow will determine how much your employment grows. And this you must be hearing from Manmohan Singh to Arun Jaitley across political parties, that we are growing high, we are not growing so high, now it has come down to 5.7%, it used to be 7.5%, it used to be 8%. But if you look at the employment figure, you see something quite different from what all this say. During the recent years, actually there has been negative employment. I mean, it's now more or less established in the last 3 years. I mean, I'm not only talking about the, you know, particular, this particular BJP government, but from towards the last years of the Congress government, the second United Front of whatever. Employment has been deteriorating, and if you, the best simple way of seeing this is to look at the years of high growth. When China was growing 3 times the international average, approximately 9 to 10%, world GDP was growing at about something close to 2%, China was growing something close to 9%. India was growing more than double the international growth rate at that time, about 7%. These were the years of high growth till about 2011 or so. Now, if you look at those years, and if you look at the official statistics, in India, employment grew at slightly less than 1%, official statistics. Regular employment grew at slightly less than 1%. In China, regular employment grew at slightly more than 1%. So between the employment growth and output growth, there was virtually very little connection. And this is exactly one of the badly kept secrets of modern economics. High growth does not mean people are doing well. You know, there is a joke which I used to hear, and I now occasionally say it in the context when I discuss employment. It was a Latin American joke. They told me it is a true story in Mexico, but I don't know whether it was a true story. It's too good to be a true story. That apparently one of the military dictators of Latin America, who was supported by the US military and so on, had to regularly go and report how is this country doing. So he went to the President of the United States, and the President asked him, well, how are things? So he said, sir, things are fine, there is no report, no revolution, law and order is fine. And then he said, but what about growth? So he said, well, the economy is growing, sir, the economy is growing very high, very fast. So the any problem, he said, no problem, except that people say they are not doing well at all. My intelligence says people are very, very, says that, you know, the government might say that growth is 8%, 9%, but the people say they are not very happy at all. So this is the case of the country is doing very well, the economy is doing very well, but the people are not doing too well. And this is very largely the case with India, if you are not too hooked on TV channels and such things. Actually, with the change in the growth rates and with the change in the output, actually the employment situation does not seem to be better, very much better or worse. Average people's standard of living does not seem to be very much better or worse. Now, we what is there which has changed, for which it has not, which has become like this. Now, notice, I mean, how does a country go? Say, for example, how did India grow at 7% or even now grows at 5%? A little over 5%. How did India grow at 7%, 5% and so on, with negative employment growth, with hardly 1% employment? Where does the next remaining growth come from? Where does it come from? It comes from the growth of labor productivity, which means output per worker. Okay? Employment does not grow, but output, the same worker or the same workforce produces more output, okay, which you call labor productivity. So labor productivity per head, labor productivity grows at a much faster rate. It was growing at 6%, now it's growing at about 4% and so on. Now, suddenly what has changed that labor productivity grows so much? One of the things which has changed, and I'm coming to the main thing now, which is our, one of the things which has changed is the agent, what is called today the growth agent or the development agent, which used to be the state, has gradually shifted to the large corporations, partly by design, partly not by design, but anyway, it has changed from the, definitely from the, it has come from the state-led growth, state-led industrialization to a largely corporate-led growth, corporate-led industrialization. It's not good or bad on its own. This is true in India, this is true in China, this is true all over the world. If you have any inquisitive mind, you should ask why. One of the reasons why it has changed is that if with globalization, if you have to compete in the international markets, you need an international chain. You need to be, you know, you need to have access to the international market in various ways.